Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised, and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
Tepaya.
Asam.
Yedafi.
Tepuhoya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Together we pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, you are welcome to Living Streams of Water. Today, we celebrate with the Church the memorial of Saint Josephite, Bishop and Martyr of the Church. Josephite was seen, or he's seen as a patron, for the reunion of Greek and Latin churches. He was born in Ukraine in the year 1580. He became a Catholic and then a monk and priest of the Order of Saint Basil. He became Archimandrite and later Archbishop of Pollok. He had a zeal and dedication for the bishop. He worked very hard for Christian unity until the year 1623. He suffered martyrdom at the hands of those who oppose his efforts. Beloved in Christ, what have you also sacrificed for the church? What do you continue to sacrifice for the church? And how are you helping in making the mission of the church in the world more relevant to all? Today, I would like to reflect with you with the first reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to Philemon. Beloved, I have derived much joy and comfort from your love, my brother, because the heart of the saints has been refreshed through you. Accordingly, though I am bold enough in Christ to command you to do what is required, yet, for love's sake, I prefer to appeal to you. I, Paul, an ambassador and now a prisoner also for Christ Jesus, I appeal to you for my child Onesimus, whose father I have become in my imprisonment. Formerly, he was useless to you, but now he is indeed useful to you and to me. I am sending him back to you, sending my own very heart. I would have been glad to keep him with me, in order that he might serve me on your behalf during my imprisonment for the gospel. But I prefer to do nothing without your consent, in order that your goodness might not be my compulsion, but of your own free will. Perhaps this is why he was parted from you for a while, that you might have him back forever, no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, as a beloved brother, especially to me, but how much more to you, both in flesh and in the Lord. So, if you consider me your partner, receive him as you would receive me. If you had wronged you at all, or owns you anything, charge that to my account. I, Paul, write this with my own hand. I will repay it, to say nothing of your owning me, even your own self. Yes, brother, I want some benefit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. The word of the Lord. Beloved in Christ, today as we celebrate the memorial of Saint Josephite, a bishop and monk, and we read this letter from Saint Paul to Philemon, it gives me great joy, because this letter looks like a kind of a recommendation letter. A recommendation letter sent through Onesimus to give to Philemon, so that he may see Onesimus not as a slave, not as a servant, but a brother in the same mission. A brother who no longer as just a common slave or a servant, but a beloved one who is coming to help him, who is there to support him, who is there to become partner with him for the mission that is ahead. So it is with Saint Josephite. He sought to bring Christian communities together. He sought to bring the Western Church and the Eastern Church together. He sought to bring the Latin Church and the Greek Church together. And that was the prayer of our Lord Jesus Christ, that they may all be one. But one of the things that I want you to learn from St. Paul's writing to Philemon is that it is one of the letters in the Bible that has only one chapter. Number one. Number two, it's one of the writings in the Bible that gives a vivid recommendation from St. Paul's hand, because he says that, I, Paul, I am writing this with my own hands. An expression that it is not somebody who have written the recommendation. He is the one who have experienced the person, lived with the person, learned under the person, and have seen the good works for which Philemon, Onesimus, can always give to Philemon. Beloved, number three. The recommendation is to let Philemon understand that Onesimus is a changed person. As a changed person, he is changed, one, as physically, as one who was destroying the church and coming now to save the church, and again given a new mission, because he says that he is going to be with Philemon both in flesh and in the Lord. My dear brother, my dear sister, many of us, as we go to church each day, should see the collaborativeness, should feel the presence of God within the community that we live in, within the sacraments that is being offered, and again, within the individual participation within the community. Some of us come to church and we become like markers. We only want to see people commit the error, and we begin to ask, oh, see, he didn't even read it well. The word was not well pronounced. We become markers. Hey, look at somebody, he has fallen. Hey, look at somebody's shirt. We become markers and lookers in church. But you are seated there. You could have read nicely, what is your participation in the mass? What is your collaboration to help God's people worship God better? You are there. People are coming in and going out. Have you ever been an usher? To usher somebody into the church and to help the person find a place to sit? Have you ever even come to the church to find a broom to sweep or a duster to clean for you to also become a collaborator? My dear brother, my dear sister, there are many things that we can do to collaborate with each other. I cannot do it all. You cannot do it all. But the recommendation given by St. Paul to be sent to Philemon by Onesimus, it's something that you can also do each day. I often tell my youth, if you don't do anything in the parish and you are asked to come to me for a recommendation, what can I write about you? You don't belong to any youth society in the church. You don't do any activity to help in the progress of the church. On Sunday, we would be celebrating in my parish here in Tamale, Partnership Day, Culture Day, and also we'll celebrate our Feast Day. Ask yourself, how many, I'll not only speak about the youth, how many of us will even come to church that very day? We'll give a lot of excuses. The church will be too long. Even the things that we'll do, I don't even have my traditional wear. I can't even cook my traditional food. These are excuses that you give. If you have come to me to write a recommendation for you, what can I write? I don't see you in church. I don't know what you do. Each and every one of us want to stay behind something to give reason. But the issue is your collaboration, my collaboration, your partnership, my partnership, what you do, the function you play, and what I play, all comes together to form and to help in the celebration of God. May the Lord continue on to touch our hearts each day, to do the little things that St. Teresa of Avila will talk about, to do the little things that St. Teresa of the Child Jesus will speak about, so that the little you do, the little that I will do, will become something that God himself will give you a recommendation for the greater good of your life and your salvation. May the Lord continue to bless and keep you. May his face shed its light upon you and grant you his peace. And may he bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed day.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
Tepaya.
Asankush.
Yedase.
Tepuhoya.